update. One reason why Earthmen continue to commit all manner of atrocities in our zone. Our Southeast governors moved to set up the zone security outfit, which they said would be community-based. Some stakeholders have said the body would curb crimes, particularly the activities of rogue herdsmen. His word says, "We advise our leaders to ensure that our core rural areas where these herdsmen terrorists have destroyed farmlands, kill, rape and maim, will be well fortified." Already, some of the states like Enugu have put in place forest guards who patrol the forest and provide intelligence to security agencies. This group has to be fortified more and even their numbers increase and ensure that they also patrol farmlands. Again, one of the most important measures to be adopted is to ban herdsmen from having camps in the forest and bushes. This is one reason they have continued to commit all manner of atrocities in our zone, like Delta government is trying to do. Herdsmen will no longer be allowed to live in forests in the Southeast. They should be made to hire or lease or purchase land fenced it and rear their animals. Our brothers doing business in the north do not live in the bush and do not get shops free. They pay for homes and shops, do their business and go home after they work. This must apply to the herdsmen. They have to follow modern trends in animal rearing. Nobody will allow them to continue with the old ways which have been creating problems. Also, a former boss of Afiku South Local Government Area of Ebonyi State, Chief Eni Chima, applauded the initiative. According to him, the proposed security architecture would enhance the security affair and psychologically well-being of the people of the zone. He said that the Southeast Committee policy will eliminate the siege mentality in some quarters, especially if it will stop the prevalent multiplicity of checkpoints understood by people of the zone as extortion point. By the participation of the people in their own security apparatus, confidence is built and efficiency achieved, because peculiar security challenges are properly treated even with caution. They are also treated with homemade solutions as well. The security outfit will definitely synchronize variegated stakeholders of security actions, plans among the individual states towards attaining maximum and better quality outputs. Meanwhile, ex-deputy national secretary of the All Progressive Grand Alliance, APGA, Chief Jerry Obasi, said that for the outfit to be effective, there must be security of purpose and not politicization of the program or in any way. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this great news about this idea of introducing security outfits in Southeast. According to what the writer says, it says Southeast needs security outfits because of these herdsmen. the Southeast governor moved to set up the zone security outfit, which they said that it would be community-based. And some stakeholders have said that the body would cope crimes, particularly the activities of these herdsmen. So if this outfit is being introduced, I'm very much sure that these herdsmen will definitely flee away from the community. They will be afraid that they will be caught, and they will go off away from the community and go somewhere else. So if each state have its security, one after the other, they have their own security, I'm very much sure that Etme will never be able to perform their evil agenda anymore if they are being thrown out of different states by setting up security outfit. I'm very much sure that things will be better than the way it is as far as herdsmen is concerned. Already some of the states like Enugu have put in place forest guard who patrol the forest, and they provide intelligence to security agencies as well. So this group, these forest guards, has to be fortified more, and even their numbers should be increased, and ensure that they also patrol farmlands. So these people should be fortified, because these herdsmen are fortified as well and are very strong. So I urge the Enugu governor to please, since he has put in place forest guard, he has said the forest guard should patrol the forest and provide intelligence to security agencies. Definitely they will be caught, but before doing that, they should be fortified so that this herdsmen will not conquer them. So that the herdsmen will not conquer them is a good idea that this security outfit is about to be set up. And I love this. I love this. This is wonderful. This is a good talk. It's a good talk. So at George Ndigbo should bring up their agenda like Amotekun did. They should not bribe. Don't allow them. Don't bribe. Don't be bribed, because they will come and stop you from organizing or for setting up this outfit. So don't listen to them. Do your mind. Do that which you want to do, so that all this mess, Kwaram, herdsmen invading people's lives, properties, raping, mining, and all of that, we put an end to. Let this search to all this, or all those, let it be certain. Let the search be certain. This guard that have been sent to the forest in Enugu should please set their community, organize their community with security outfit. And those that have set up the security outfit and have refused to let it, to activate it, should please do that now. Let's drive away these people from bushes and from forest, because they are hiding in the forest, which they should be chased out. If they are being chased out by setting up security outfit, I'm very much sure that nobody will even chase them, and nobody there won't be a need for any guide to chase them out. All the security outfit will be the one to drive them out and drive them away, never to come back to Nigeria, and the activities will definitely end. So no one should sell and portion, no one should sell and portion of land to those elders. They will come and say, "She sent portion of land to them." Don't allow them to deceive you. You can lease land to them, but not outright sales. God will give us enough signs and warning in this issue, because those people are animals. They say they are human beings, but they are animals. And animals don't stay together. Their lives is all about killing. Killing and killing and killing. At the slightest provocation, they kill. So remember, in Igbo land, it is a taboo to be pouring human blood away. It's a taboo to be pouring human blood away, so they should not even allow that to happen. They should not sell their portion of land to these herdsmen. They will come and deceive them, but they should not listen. So viewers, what is your take on this? Your comment is so needed. Drop them below the comment box. Click on the subscribe button as well as the bell button to receive updates whenever I publish new videos. And don't forget, share and like this news as well. Thank you.